Yo, 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 yo! What's happening?
What's good? What's good?
Hey, hey. Welcome to Millionaire Minds. It's your boy, Cali Bo.
Yes.
It's your girl, your official.
Girl. Yes.
Nobody felt that. Nobody. Brother, what's your name?
It's your boy, the official legacy of the legend, Prince True Being in the building.
You want to sing too?
Huh?
You want to sing too?
Not right now.
Not right now. Okay. All right. Yeah.
I was just feeling that.
No, nobody
so I just had to give it to you guys because I am in a good mood. You know how sometimes you feel the energy kind of shift when you have a conversation with somebody and your whole mood just changes?
Right.
I just really just had to say that. So I just had to say that. So again, like Callie said, thank you guys for tuning in on yet again another Monday with your people from Millionaire Minds, our Success Radio Show. Yes, single Monday, 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. is where you can catch us. You can go ahead and go to your Facebook Live page, go to George Jones page, and you will be able to see our live feed right now. So we're going to actually share it to all of our groups, all of our pages, and make sure that you guys share it as well. So.
That's what's happening. What's up, man?
I just want to know how everybody's weekend went.
You know what? I'm going to go last. Because the man over here, he had something big going on this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'd rather him go first because it's a question that I want to ask him.
Okay.
So, Mr. True. Yeah. The official True King.
The official, the legendary prince himself.
How the fuck was your weekend?
My weekend was lit, actually.
Lit. That's what's happening.
What happened? Yeah. What did you have going on?
I went on it's a tour called Motown and More, and we cover Motown type songs, like Temptations, The Tramps, The Four Tops, The Female Do Supremes, Martha the Dell, Gladys Knight, the Pips. So,
who was David Ruffin? Who played David Ruffin? Huh? That's what I'm talking about.
Who was David Ruffin? Was it you?
It was him. Well, look. Y'all look sharp though, man. Y'all look real sharp.
Yes,
but it was one picture. Like one picture. I want to ask you about.
Okay.
All right. Uh-huh. Why the hell, or no, I'm not going to accuse you. I want to ask you. Was his head on your shoulder?
Nah.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
From the picture, like, it looked like his cheek is, like, smushed in. Like, and I was going to ask, like, bro, like, okay, I don't know which part of Motown that was. Is that the case? Like, I don't know.
Nah,
that was Tevin.
Nah, you can zoom in to see that.
It's a little space between them. Yeah. Okay. All right.
Oh my God.
For real, like they were sharp.
We had
they
to,
took the pictures.
We had to squeeze in and to the frame.
Okay.
You know, so
that's the story we're going with. We're going with that.
We're going to go with that.
Yeah. See, that wasn't said.
So he's safe now. He's okay?
Yeah.
He gets a pass?
Yeah, he gets a pass.
Well, thank you.
Well, I am glad that you had an awesome show. The next one, you have to let us know so that we can let all the listeners and the viewers know so that if they have an opportunity to attend, you know, if it's a public event, we can all come and support you and just see y'all show up.
David Ruffin!
And drops the mic. But seriously, though, so, yeah.
How was your weekend?
I think it was great.
Great.
Yeah. I had a very productive weekend. Yesterday, I was so tired. But Friday and Saturday, you know, we definitely, when I say we, you and I. Shared an event on Saturday.
What was that event?
Shout out to our London industry family.
Lock Entertainment.
The real A&R and Miss Shanae. Yes, you guys, we love you guys so very much.
Yes,
we hope that you are tuned in. If not, guess what? you will be and you will listen to the playback.
Exactly.
But we really appreciate you guys extending this opportunity to us and allowing us to be ourselves and share the wonderful event that they had, you guys. It was at the Music Lounge Live. It was presented by GOLD, which is Gift of Abundant Love, and they are a charity, and what they do is they give back through music, and they will put together the platforms that we were actually a part of, like Saturdays, you have the opportunity to showcase your talent. We have some great talent there.
Yes. shout out to Senna.
Yes.
Shout out to Gutter, Chifa, Jay Father Licorice, Love. Father True.
Father True.
Father True. Them eyes, those
the
eyes.
Real eyes.
The real eyes. Like the real eyes took us back to church. I said Gutter. I didn't miss Rico Styles.
Yeah.
Chifa, Senna. I hope I'm not missing nobody. I'm pretty sure that's everybody.
Man, look,
shouts out to them. Oh, DJ King Rudy.
Yes, shouts out to DJ King Rudy. Shout out to you. Yes.
Man, look, it was a great movement. I enjoyed every minute of it. Shout out to the security guard. Shout out to him.
Yeah, he was doing his thing. He was doing his thing.
I think he halfway secure and shit because he didn't have a badge, so I thought he just figured I'll walk around.
He had one of our badges.
For real. So we were security too. I wasn't gonna stop shit. Just let it happen. the food was good as well.
Yes.
Like tacos and everything.
Shout out to you, Viv.
Yes,
you definitely
it
did
was,
that thing.
It was on
that
point.
Beef and potato wrap,
that was definitely
though.
On point.
Oh, y'all just don't know.
That was lit, man.
And the whole purpose of it, though. Which I think that we have to make sure that everyone understands at the beginning of the show that on the flyer, I know it mentioned something about the tips were going to be given to the artists as they were performing. So you had the opportunity to throw your ones or throw your money.
Musical stripping.
Musical stripping. Good way to put it.
Yeah. Throw them ones. Make it rain.
And, you know, a certain percentage goes to the artist, and that's just a way of, you know, giving back to them for showcasing their talent to you guys. And you too, if you're an artist, you have that opportunity as well. So you want to make sure that you are supporting a good cause. You guys, donation was only $3 in advance on Eventbrite, and it was $5 at the door.
Right.
So at the end of the day, it is very little. I mean, most of you guys probably spend with $5 at KFC and $5 box or Taco Bell. So I mean, you know, if you have it to spare, you know that it's going to the cause. You have to invest in yourself. So at the end of the day, you have to bring three people with you as well. So I mean, hey, we have the next one in a couple of months. So you guys just stay tuned on that.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah.
So what did you take from the event?
I was tired.
You was tired.
Nah. Oh, wait, you know what? Shout out to Centric Magazine.
Yes, Centric
Magazine.
Oh, they were awesome people.
Shout out to the cameraman, all right? I mean, at this event, you know what? This is what I took from this event, all right? You can be part of staff, but you can, have a good time because between the security guard and the cameraman, who did a great job taking pictures.
Yes.
I'm talking about when we had music break. Man, this dude was on the dance floor. These fools challenged me to a step off like I pledged to. I'm just they sitting there stomping everything. Someone calling me. Why? I should answer this on air, but then again, it might be a bill collector.
Yeah, don't ignore it.
Yeah, we're gonna hit that. Unless they call back. You know what? If you ever notice, that's why most people don't get calls back. Cause if you are friends with somebody, 9 out of 10, you text them first.
That's true.
Yeah.
I always tell people to text me first. Because I respond to a text first.
Exactly.
Before I respond to a call.
That's cool. So I'm not the only one who don't like talking on the phone.
No, because texting is better. You say just right to the point on the phone. I don't like being on the phone a long period of time because that dead silence.
Yeah.
It's like in that awkwardness in between conversations. I feel text me, text you back. We good.
And at the same time, like it's better for you because I could choose to ignore your call.
Right.
You might really need something. It really might be important. But at the same time, I don't like talking on the phone.
Right.
So better yet, you just text me, get to the point, and then I can choose to read it, and you can know I read it. Mm-hmm. If you get a response back, then you know what the answer was. Right. See? Yeah, smart.
It works. I mean, hey, everybody has their vice and the thing that irritates them. And I know that's those things, so,
yeah, just went off subject, so
it is what it is. But right. Anywho, yes.
What are we talking about today?
We have some trending topics to definitely discuss. We definitely want to get some of your input or your thoughts on some of these topics, you guys. So we definitely have some news that we want to cover, you guys. We have some tea that we're going to be exposing. We have sports with Calipo.
Yeah.
We have a little bit of shade versus sarcasm. You know, you got some folks that want to be funny out here.
Yeah.
So, you know, when you do stuff, you got to be careful because if you're being put on blast, you can't run and hide.
See me in the street, nigga.
And, you know, we definitely, it's going to lead up into who gets the oh hell no. Uh-huh. For the week.
Who will it be?
I'm just saying though. So.
I don't know, but I know like it's been somebody got it like 2 weeks running. So I don't like I got one. I mean, I don't know if y'all got one and it's the same one. We gonna retire in like 3 weeks in a row. Like they get 3 weeks in a row, they get on the Hall of Fame. Oh hell no.
Yeah.
I don't know who y'all is.
We're gonna get when we get to that. That's gonna be up in the second half. So you guys gotta stay tuned in to hear about that. So we're definitely gonna go into some of my lightning round.
Yeah.
And we're gonna also do who's the plug session. So you know, we definitely wanna just pay homage to people who either kind of are the reason why we are here. We also want to take time out at that moment to spotlight someone who we may feel is very important to know in the industry. Like I said on Saturday, you never know who you are standing next to. You never know who you may actually bump into. So it is very important not to burn bridges.
Yep.
Because eventually you have to come right back to that person that you screwed over.
Yep.
Who do you know? So, again, y'all just have to stay tuned. So when we get to those topics,
I would if I was
you guys can get all the tea. Yes.
Man, you're going to have people like wanting us to skip everything else and like go straight to the tea.
Not happening.
Because you kind of put a spin on that, like, you're going to start out good.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to get ratchet. Somebody might get called out their name. And then at the end of all that, somehow we gonna get real religious and like thank God at the end of it. Just so you know, just like it's gonna have all those emotions in one. Like that's just how you painted it. Like mine's not gonna go like that. Like mine's myself. Like
yours might start a fight?
No, I'm just playing. You know,
I don't fight.
I don't fight people.
I don't know about that. He may fight.
Who?
You when was the last time you got into a fight?
I don't know. I really don't. Like, I don't fight, like, all the time. Like, when you say fight, what do you mean fight?
A fight fight. Like, where you had to throw some hands.
At who?
Whoever. Whoever. That doesn't matter.
Does family count?
Yes, family count. Especially family.
You know what? Nah, I ain't had a fist fight in a minute, man. Like, I've been on my grown man stuff. Like, I kind of tend to learn to walk away. But at the same time, like, I stay in my own lane, so, and then at that, like, when people I have altercations with people, like the invite is there, but I think at the same time, like, they be on their grown man, I be on my grown man. It's like, it really ain't the point. Now, I ain't got that way with some people, and by the time I've been there with some people, we won't cross paths, and, you know, I just think that's, like, what they say, God's plan?
Yeah.
Yeah, we wasn't supposed to cross paths. Like, we, at the end of the day, like, fighting was really for kids and stuff like that, so... I don't know. I think the last, I was in my 20s. Tell you that. I was in my 20s.
So I do have a question about that. What? So I would love to hear you guys' input on this. I just want to know.
You asking me the question?
Anybody, everybody. So when we come back from our break, we can actually delve back into this because I really want to know, is there a time or an age where fighting... It's just like, okay, like, really, like, why are you fighting? You're too old. Like, you know, because you have people who are in their 30s and in their 40s who will throw hands if the situation calls for it. So, is there a situation where you're supposed to, like, ignore those type of provoking situations and walk away? Or do you still commit to throw them hands?
All right, you know what? Yeah, I'll go.
Okay, go ahead.
I mean, are you want to go to break first? Or
no,
you
we got 4 minutes before we go to break. We got some time.
All right, well, I mean, so, with all honesty, like, I think after high school, you really shouldn't be over that fight. Like, really, in school, you shouldn't be fighting anybody.
Right.
But we know, like, most kids, that's the only way they know how to handle their, like, handle their issues. So, I would say at that point, once you... hit that point of adulthood, you know, where you're supposed to be an adult,
right?
Not in school no more. I'm just saying, I said supposed to be,
okay?
Supposed to be,
right?
All right, supposed to be an adult, but you were, you know what I'm saying? You might slide back and forth here and there,
right.
And that's all right, because right. You're learning. But as you grow into that adulthood and you get more into paying bills, getting a job, understanding that, like, if you don't have kids, somebody kids is looking at you.
Right.
You know, if you have kids on your own, they're looking at you. So, is there a point to where, like, what do you want your kids to see?
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Like, me, honestly, I don't want my son to be, to have, to grow up, you know, fighting and building angry like that. I want him to learn how, now don't get it twisted. He gonna learn how to kick your kid's ass. Okay? Just so you know that he's gonna learn that and gonna know.
Right.
But that needs to be the last option and only in self defense. Gonna teach you to learn to walk away, learn to identify the situation. If it's something that's not your issue, step back, go on about your business. Right. If it's something that is that can actually be talked out, get the point across. But have respect with it, because at the end of the day, if that if it gets to that point and is brought to you, after you lay this punk out on the ground, you can actually stand over him knowing that you brought this on to yourself.
True.
And hopefully, and really, like, when one, and that's the difference between, like, being the leader, being a follower. With all honesty, when two people are about to fight, that's the most important time where they need leadership.
Right.
Because, like, you've never seen, unless it was just that type of situation, but you've never seen one be the bigger man and the next not follow.
Mm-hmm.
You've never seen that. Like, you've never seen two grown men, they might get to tussling for a second.
Right.
Be pulled apart. Still be wolfing.
Yeah.
Trying to get back at each other.
Right.
Until one of them actually, like, man, you know, this ain't even working. Might even say that to a man, it didn't work, but I wasn't even trying. Like, really, what's really going on?
Mm-hmm.
And at some point, either it's going to be, I don't know, shit, why were we fighting in the first place? Mm-hmm. Or just fucking walk away.
Right.
So, really, at some point, just learn to be that leader. So, I think that's when you get into that adulthood and you learn there's other options.
Right.
You know, you have a lot more to lose. As a child, you fight in public, you just go home.
Right.
Take a shower, lick your wounds.
Yeah.
As an adult, you get caught fighting. Take your ass to jail.
Used to get into a fight and you used to be able to walk away. Nowadays, most of the time, folks ain't even fighting. They got the gun.
Yeah.
They may have the knife. Like, they ain't even trying to throw hands. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, I don't know. A lot of things have changed. And we think about it, this is exactly what they want. You know, so we're so busy going at each other. I mean, if you want to resolve a problem, just going to get it out the way. Go outside. If you got gloves, get that.
But
everybody just kind of stay back. You know, it's not like that.
But like you said, it's not the same. You got to think about it. Nowadays,
when you do throw hands, they taking everybody. I don't think they just taking whoever was the aggressor.
It's both of y'all.
Everybody. Both of y'all. Or all of y'all.
Like 9 out of 10, it's the people throwing hands. Like, they're going to jail. It's been many times, like, I remember Central Station days. Central Station days. Like, so, yeah. ATL folks out there.
Right.
Central Station days on a Friday night, Southside. You already know what it is. When you get to the front door, 12 already outside with the paddy wagon.
Yo.
And depending on what time you got there, it was already about 3-4 folks in there.
Yes. And guess what?
They not getting out until 6 o'clock in the morning, and they still gotta go to jail. So they gotta spend. And that's the thing. Like, that's what I was thinking about. Like, bro, hold on. You mean tell me if I get caught fighting in the club, whether I get my ass kicked if I win, I'm getting put in this little thing back here, and I'm about to sit. All right, from the time the club closed, then we going to jail.
Yep.
All right, then I got to worry about getting out. And that's a Saturday, so I ain't getting out to Monday. So, hell no. And if you ain't never been in the back of one of them vans.
Never been there.
Just trying to tell you. Boy.
Yes, but man. True, do you have anything on that?
I did, but my brother has swayed my decision. Because I can't do jail, so I agree with him 100%. Being an adult, be a damn adult.
That's right.
At the same time, too, everybody ain't built the same. Like,
that's true.
Like, you can look at a man and sit there and know that, all right, me and you got to throw hands.
Right.
This situation ain't gonna be over with until me and you actually throw some hands.
Right.
Then you got
we go out back, though, but even some of the marshmallows, even some of the muffins. They know we just got to throw some hands for 30 seconds, and after that, we cool. Like, if you get like, I got people like that. Like, I've had friends like that. Okay, you know what? Whatever it is, it's not clicking.
Right.
You still going to be around one. They go to the. Because, you know, folks shooting these days, like you said.
Yeah,
kids shooting these days. Everybody scared of last week. Social media got everybody fucked up.
That's all good. But you guys, we will go ahead and go into a break.
Yeah, yeah.
So this time, you can go ahead and just gather your snacks, get yourself together, share the live feed, and when it comes up, go ahead and share that. But we are going to go ahead and let you guys enjoy a few great tracks from some of our indie artists. And we'll definitely let you guys know who they are when we come back, and we will definitely get into our segments.
Yeah, yeah.
So we appreciate you guys listening to Millionaire Minds, a Car 2 Cents radio show on WAENFM.com, you guys. Stay tuned.
W-Ball.
Yes, sir.
Listen, I remember waking up to a stick of butter in the refrigerator. We didn't even have a kitchen table. I can't lie. That's the reason why I am now. So I'm thankful. Sad to see so many mamas cry. Back to back funerals every other week. My son 17 doing 20 today. Yeah. I see this shit every day, one. But those are rock, cause I'm running, this is the going on. Yeah. But I love where I'm from. And everybody that came up with me. Been locked up with me. Had struggle with me. They know the struggle. They know the shit. Give me that. But the fight looking there 20 years now. These are the days of my life. I ain't trying to rap. Cause I don't know how they life, but it's even the children and wife. But it's young, cause you sure you ready. Crushing my stomach for sacrifice. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mama, don't cry. Wipe your eye. Everything gon' be alright. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you gotta do. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Even though I ain't even right. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mama, don't cry. Wipe your eye. Everything gon' be alright. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you gotta do. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do, even though I ain't living right. I remember being hungry, no food, and the butter count checking in the refrigerator. We ain't living on the square, apartment so small, barely had room for a kitchen table. So that why, a young nigga, looking like a hustle, cause I really came up from nothing. But I'm trying to make my mama proud, cause I'm tired of making mama cry. Cause the son in the field trying to get it how he lives, but that's just how he is in the field. Still hit my goodness, and you either gonna end up in jail, or get yourself killed. I can't give my trust to none of these. Stay to myself, cause niggas ain't real. They fuck with you long as you're doing something. But folks to turn on you, yeah, I know how I feel. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mama, don't cry. Wipe your eye. Everything gon' be alright. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you gotta do. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Even though I ain't living right. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mama, don't cry. Wipe your eye. Everything gon' be alright. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you gotta do. Lights out. Gotta do what you gotta do. Even though I ain't living right. Gotta stop the fight.
Strong. Yeah, yeah. I know you going through a lot right now. Doing everything on your own.
Keep pushing, mama.
Yeah. See, you know what I say, that I'm proud of you.
So proud of you.
I adore you. I take my hair off to you, cause you a hell of a woman. Playing a mother and a father. It's some of the things that a man puts a woman through.
So
you wanna know why I act the way I do. Now I can't say, when a woman fed up, ain't no coming back. Once you pick herself up, ain't no turning back. Tired of getting cheated on. Ain't tired of getting lied to. Ain't tired of putting their hold on their life for you. And you're not doing what you're supposed to do. Yeah, yeah. So many nights you call her. Rather be with that side piece to air on. She keep calling and calling. Pick up the phone. Now you wanna act a fool and try to move on. I don't run the streets to be with her. Outside the womb. True love, everything that you do in the dark come to the light. When I came by love, now you got somebody wild. Yeah, I can't lie, you a blessing. I want you to stop all your stressing. If you gon' do what you supposed to do, you know what you gotta do. Yeah, I can't lie, you a blessing. I want you to stop all your stressing. If you gon' do what you supposed to do, you know what you gotta do. Baby, you a blessing. I can't lie, you a blessing. Baby, you a blessing. And you know you was a blessing.
Yeah, every energy's about. Real, you now she taking out. Been back in school, now she graduated. She a natural, but also not do what it takes.
Now, baby, all I'm on about. Now she rockin' red ball.
Know you're that bad. Make it talk back. You deserve everything you got. That is a fact. Yeah.
just wanna see you have some. I just wanna tell you some of my world. You been through enough now. Try to let go of your problems, let it out. Just cause he know what he had. Just cause he know you was a blessing. When I look at you, I see a queen. When I look at you, I see a team. Baby, tour the world with me. Baby, you was all I need. Somebody else trash, somebody trash. Since you let go, now your life much better. Hey, I can't lie, you a blessing. I want you to stop all that stress. If you gon' do what you supposed to do, you know what you gotta do. Hey, I can't lie, you a blessing. I want you to stop all that stress. If you gon' do what you supposed to do, then you know what you gotta do.
Teriyaki. You stingy with the sound. You might as well work at McDonald's. All these do a flip. You might as well be a body builder. When I met her, she ain't her nowhere. Now she think it's the I'm a body builder.
Now I just set my step. Used to have to hold my britches. Now the holster on the belt. I hit 11, naughty. Couldn't get right, so shot 11. Got addicted to the digits. There's nothing you can tell me. Deal with the f*** going on. 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 Deal with the f*** going on.
Deal with the f*** going on. Luda finally came home. If it ain't about a dollar, you can't lead them right when you wrong. Study f***ing all these f***ing chasing that bread and I'm still pimping. Used to be a D to kick in. Check game, keep my interest. And I
keep the missiles with me. Tickets on delivery. Gotta keep it with me cause they envy me. All that second fake is be killing me. That's another story with no empathy. Two-stepping on them like that Kale's thing. When we hit the club, we gon' make the scene. TSYB, she been over snatching things. Better cup your chicken cause she digging deep until she realize what it's digging me. Have her hypnotized by the fly beam. She contaminated to the present thing. Look me in my eyes, see a money scheme. It's a kid a bag over everything. She ain't beneficial, tell me what the need. But equation will equal out you.
Used to be a little kid, now I just set me myself. Used to have to hold my bridges, now the holster on the belt. I ain't 11, not even, couldn't get right, so shot 11. Got addicted to the digits, now there's nothing you can tell me. Deal with the f*** going on, deal with the f*** going on. Deal with the f*** going on, deal with the f*** going on. Deal with the f*** going on, deal with the f*** going on. Deal with the f*** going on, deal with the f*** going on.
Yeah, 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 we back!
For real? Yeah, that's how you feel?
Yeah, hey. Yeah. That's yes, how I feel. You yes. Sing, I scream.
Yes. Oh, you know what? That works. That works, that works. We have to be able to express ourselves. I'm just saying, though. Just keep it 100, though, so we appreciate you for expressing. Thank you. Thank you. What? I'm not even being sarcastic.
Everybody out there, listen to me. On three, we gonna scream, all right? No, on three. One, two, three.
Ah! Real true? You just scream? No, he is purring right now.
Hey, look, all that extra shit. You know, I said scream, you purr. Nah, fuck all that, all right?
Yes, you guys, thank you so much for tuning in to Millionaire Minds with our 2 cents radio show. Each and every Monday is where you can catch us right here on WAENFM.com and WAENTV.com from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. We are going to go ahead and go straight into some trending news, you know, a little entertainment, gossip, you know, maybe a little tea, a little bit later on, some sports. But we definitely want to go ahead and say that we welcome Rick Ross back. He's home from the hospital.
Yeah,
he was there for 4 days. They found him very early Monday morning. Apparently, they found him unresponsive. And, you know, it kind of just went from there. There was a little hiccup with TMZ reporting. Exactly what was going on with him, and they were saying that he was in.
He said he was on life support.
On life support.
Was he or was he not on life support?
Someone from Rick Ross's camp confirmed that he was not on life support. That he was actually doing better than what they were reporting. So, but they still appreciate everybody for, you know, praying and just keeping him uplifted. So he is back home.
Yeah.
So you know that's good for him. So yes. And you guys, Terry Crews.
Okay.
So.
Wow. Okay. Well, wow. Hey, wait. Before you get to Terry, because that's Terry. Let me ask you a question. All right. Was it just me, or did the rest of y'all get sad when y'all heard? Like, I kind of got sad.
Terry Crews.
Yeah. I'm Terry Crews. All right.
Oh God.
Like, no, I'm saying, because, like, I don't know, because when I heard it, I kind of was just like, no, not wrong. And, like,
that's what you said
I was just like, damn.
Yeah.
Not wrong.
Yeah. You know just, what?
Yeah.
That was very,
Yes, I got mild. Sad, Mad Dog. Yes, I got sad, Mad Dog. I did. I listened to, like, 6 of his songs.
But,
deep in the rap.
I mean, I felt bad, you know, because you definitely don't want to hear about anyone having to be hospitalized for anything that could be life-threatening. I mean, they said that, I think, he had a situation with pneumonia.
Yeah,
So, you know, that's not something to play with. So, you know,
that's
I
serious.
Felt bad for him, I did.
Death is never nothing to play with, man. Never nothing to play with. So,
yeah.
So, shouts out to Rick, man. We happy that you home.
Yeah.
Please, please, please take your time. Get yourself together.
Yes.
And then, you know, come on back to the game. We miss you.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So, back to Terry Crews, I read that he has agreed to take a mental health exam in connection with his sexual assault lawsuit that he filed against the agent that he claimed groped him at a party. Have you guys heard about that? Hold on, because you got some, no, it's a lot of words in this
that she said that should not kind of go together, like rope, mental health, sex, what the
listen
fuck?
To me, though, because he actually filed a lawsuit, a sexual assault lawsuit against an agent that he claimed groped him at a party. Yes, like he went and told. Okay? So.
Wait, he went, who did he go tell? I bet he went told the popo. So someone went for
Terry Crews.
Terry Crews.
Like big Terry Crews.
From White Chicks, Terry Crews.
The dude.
With the whistle.
Like.
Is that who you talking about? Not with the whistle.
The Old Spice guy.
What?
Is that him? Wait, is the guy that's him? Hey, hold on.
What?
He got groped?
Who and ran to the boat to do that?
No,
that's a big man.
Hold on, you missing the big picture. He got groped and ran to the police like a little bitch. I'm sorry, Terry. So once again, going back to what you said at the beginning of the show, right?
Right.
When should you not fight as a grown man?
That's a moment that you should fight because you're grown.
Yeah, like, I'm just saying, like, that's... Yeah, you touched me. I can kick your ass. And even as a celebrity, if he groped you, you have free will to kick him. Trust me, I've seen so many, like, concerts.
Yeah.
I remember a dude touched T.I. ass, and he kicked him. Ain't nothing happened to T.I. Because it got shown on it, like they can see it.
Listen,
and I might be wrong, so Tip, if you're listening to this, the story might be wrong, so don't quote me.
But see, just in continuation to that, see, the lawyer for the agent, his name is Adam Bennett, they actually filed stipulation in the civil lawsuit that Terry Crews filed. And the stipulation says that he has to agree to a mental health exam. And the health exam will take 7 hours.
What?
And they name the doctor who will perform the exam.
Wait a minute. He's taking a mental health exam. Who's taking it? Terry Crews?
Yeah.
Why is he taking a mental health exam? Because the guy said he never touched him?
Because they want to, I guess, clear the air on the accuracy. Because he is saying that it wasn't sexual assault.
So what
the fuck happened?
You have to go back, you guys, and look up the Terry Crews story and go do your research on that, because it is pretty lengthy. It is a little confusing, but in a nutshell, he has agreed to taking this mental health exam.
What?
Yeah.
Hey, okay, real quick.
So everything is currently under investigation, and that's pretty much all the news that we know about that. So, yeah.
Shout out to Mad Dog, who just said that he might be sweet. That's a sellout role. I don't like bashing like people, but Mad Dog, Hanky Panky in Hollywood. All right, shout out. Hey, you know what, Mad Dog? You're absolutely right. Keep it coming.
I'm waiting for everything to really unfold. So once everything comes out, you guys, we'll definitely keep you guys tuned in to all of the latest with all of the crazy news that we have going on out here. And speaking of which, True.
Yes.
You got something for us, right? That was a little interesting.
Yeah, I got something for you.
Hey, we getting
what
real
you got?
R&B.
I think he's trying to pull up some receipts right now.
Yeah, I'm trying to get my receipts.
What do you have?
She's good too. Hold on, y'all. Here we go.
Here we go.
Okay. All right.
It's the Love of Hip Hop production, the postponed.
You said it was postponed?
Yeah, it was postponed.
And it was postponed, what, in December, right?
Yeah, it was postponed in December. The reality show strives on real moments. So they're saying, like, it's not, it wasn't scripted.
That's
everything.
I definitely believe. And that's something I think some of them have confirmed in one way or the other that the show is scripted to a degree. I believe
reality
TV is not reality.
You know what?
TV.
I mean, I feel it has to be scripted at some point to, like, keep things on, like, flowing.
The ratings. They want to keep those ratings up. As long as they have the ratings, they can get the funding to be able to pay them want to pay them to keep them on the show and whatever else.
The atmosphere is more scripted, but, like, the actual emotions are, like, real, real, like. So, like, I just happen to know this for a fact, so we just don't know. So you guys remember, like, the Love and Hip Hop, like, a long time ago, and what's her name? Erica Dixon was on there. Shout out Erica Dixon, whatever you're doing right now. Right. And Lil Scrap Baby, right?
Mm-hmm.
That little situation happened to, because the producers were saying, like, they'll edge you on to talk about a certain issue.
Situation, right.
That they know is going to push your buttons. So so with that whole Love and Hip Hop stuff, the emotions are actually real.
Right.
They're just a bunch of, like, instigators. And don't get it twisted. Like, I love the show. So, I'm not dogging the show at all. I love the show. I don't ever want to be on one.
Right. Yeah.
But, you know, it's definitely scripted.
I believe it is scripted, to a degree.
I believe it's scripted, too. But according to this right here, it says, unfortunately, recent incidents on the set of Love & Hip Hop Atlanta were not only completely unscripted, but also highly illegal, and resulted into the injury of a member of their staff in production.
Wait, what happened? You got to say more, brother. You said it was illegal.
Somebody that was a part of the crew, a security guard, got hurt.
Right.
What happened?
Postponed due to an alleged hit and run.
Okay, what happened?
A security guard. He worked there, right?
Okay.
For the series. And then a Miami person.
A Miamian?
What happened?
Okay, well, Mimi Frost, okay? And other members from the Love & Hip Hop crew. They were preparing to shoot a scene. And one of the shoppers in the Buckhead neighborhood area was an angry mall shopper, according to this. They was upset because the production was just so slow.
Okay.
And the way that they were doing the scene, the shopper basically was mad because they didn't have a parking space.
So they were trying to park.
Right. And
this, the security guard was
doing,
like,
this job, keeping it right.
The space.
Right.
And the person hit the security guard?
Yeah. Security guard four for the show received injuries and struck the security guard with their vehicle. TMZ reported that the guard had his left leg injured and the customer went into a golf store or something.
So he hit him and went shopping?
Yeah. No, he
went into the golf store to hide.
He went to the golf store.
Before he fled the scene.
He get that 9-9, like, come at me. I seen the show before. He was looking for Stevie.
Right, yeah.
He was looking for Stevie J.
So, did they ever catch the guy?
It's still being investigated, I believe.
That mean they don't give a fuck.
But I didn't know that they have commenced. Recording taping, right?
Yeah, they said the series is set to return this year.
Oh, it is set to return.
Yeah, the VH1. Yeah.
But speaking of Love & Hip Hop, we know that Love & Hip Hop New York is on tonight.
Yes, it is.
On VH1.
So does Love & Miami.
At 8 p.m. And
Miami, Love & Hip Hop.
Love & Hip Hop Miami.
Oh, you ain't been on it?
I have, but I didn't know that they were coming on at the same time. I thought that they just kind of took turns.
You know what?
About the year. Since you have New York, then you have, I think Miami and then Atlanta.
I DVR everything, so I watch it on my own.
Bitch, I be shine. My trip on the whole nother level. Then check out the front of my sweater. I got pushing together. The ice on my kitchen and blue with the ice on my belt. On my belly, say stuffing with cheddar. And I got pills on me, bitch, and you know I'm a seller. And I'm around with that hammer. Fuck around and play with me, bitch, and you know I'm a player. Bitch, I be shine. Bitch, I be shine. Bitch, I be shine. I be shine. Lock the into. Bitch, I be shine. I be shine. Bitch, I be slide, I don't need drip no more. Packers on cross, they smoke. Water on me, won't fold. I'm making a million, gonna go. Tell Lanny be gone. Bad bitch, a little trap, nigga. She had when she see the spread. Bitch, I be dripping and moving packs. I'm stacking, I be counting up. Quarterback, I like a quarterback.
Quarterback.
I said, you can splash in that. They bust in my blood, I'm like Cracker Jack. She rolls to get what she threw it back. I fuck up for hours, ain't saying no vows. I'm in the trap, bitch, I'm still flipping pounds. I ain't got no time. Little bitch, I got a slide. Half of me, scrap on me, bitch, I be slime. My drip on the whole nother level. Then check out the front of my sweater. I put shit together. The ice on my kitchen ain't blue with the ice on my belt. On my belly, say stuffing with cheddar. And I got pills on me, bitch, and you know I'm a seller. And I'm around with that hammer. Fuck around and play with me, bitch, and you know I'm a blame.
Bitch, I be slime. Bitch, I be slime. Bitch, I be slime. Bitch, I be slime. Bitch, I be shine, I be shine.
Yeah. Bitch, I be shine, fool my money, you die. I keep my bitches in line, I let it shine on me. I don't even trip no more, I don't even trip no more. Break down my truck, then roll up my truck. I treat my niggas like brother, my nigga came from the gutter. I stole the rest of the dog for you.
Now the clips, we gon' fuck around, shoot us a movie. I got your hoe in the frame, make a move. Alright, they cool, that's a brand new brand. I walk through that big nigga, I'm sad.
Feeling like the man of the year. I get fresh in the booty of the shit. I ain't got to question my niggas, they ride. Bitch, I be shine. My drip on the whole nother level. Just check out the front of my sweater. I got a push it together. The ice on my cuban and blue with the ice on my belt. On my belly, say stuffing with cheddar. And I got pills on me, bitch, and you know I'm a seller. And I'm around with that hammer. Fuck around and play with me, bitch, and you know I'm a blame.
Bitch, I be shine, bitch, I be shine. Bitch, I be shine, I be shine. Bitch, I be shine, I be shine. Bitch, I be shine.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Lean in my cup. Lean in my cup. Bitch, I be slamming. Bitch, I be slamming.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yo, hey.
Bars.
Bars? Y'all want more bars?
Yeah.
All right. Bars. Sit up. This for you. Hey. Hey.
Okay. Yeah.
Hey. Hey, bitch, I got bars. Bitch, I got bars.
Hey.
Bitch, I got bars, water, hey. And more bars.
Hey.
Bars. Hey, Hershey, Twix.
Hey.
Hershey, Twix, hey. Peanut butter, and all that shit. Hey, you know it. Look like I got the munchies. Add me some chips. Hey. And my fucking water.
Hey.
Hey, you know it. Bars. Bars, hey, bars, hey, bars, hey, hey, bars, hey, more bars, and more bars. Give me some more bars.
Hey.
Center, I got more bars than you, son. No bars. Hey,
Center, how you like that right there? Please,
stop
the timing, man.
Hey,
you got something?
Yeah.
You gonna sing something?
I ate all my bars.
You got to sing something.
I don't have the bars. I ate all my bars.
He can't come back after that.
I want him. I
got bars.
I know y'all want to hear him just sing a little melody or something. You ain't got to have no words, huh? Come on. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, got you on the hook.
Hey,
over there. Yeah,
hey.
Hey, your hand over there. Hey, I'm over here. Hey, do your job, girl. Yeah, get your hand. You already know. Shout out Lillian Tucker. That's my cousin. Hey, Ramil, I see you. You already know. Scooby, Scooby, Doobie, Oobie, you, I see you.
Hey. Y'all, we clowning on here, man.
Bars.
We have 15 minutes left, y'all. So we just going to be clowning around. You know, we definitely want to let you guys know who we're going to be shouting out. Any events that are going to be upcoming this month, you guys, we're going to be sharing with you guys. I'm also going to do Leah Gemini's lightning round in the last 5-10 minutes. So, of course, True, go ahead and let them know about the spring fling that is coming up.
Yeah, spring fling is quickly approaching.
Yes.
It is March 24th.
Yes.
At Studio Primetime, Oak Cliff Industrial in Atlanta. And then come on out, first drink free, rest cash bar, free food. We're going to have music play all night by the lovely DJ Tony K. Loving hip hop, and there may be some other people that gonna slide on through. So y'all just come on down. The tickets are $10 in advance on Eventbrite, and $15 at the door. We're having 7 raffles actually.
Yeah.
We're having a raffle for a flat screen tea.
Yes, we are.
We're having a raffle for a his or hers massage.
Yeah. 30 minute session.
Oh yes, we have 2 comedy tickets.
2 comedy tickets to Cuts and Comedy Show, right. Y'all. Yes.
We did also have an hour slot time here at the station.
You guys. You can use that hour for anything that you want to broadcast.
Exactly.
Huh?
And we have the interview slot on our show. Mm-hmm. And everybody's at our 2 cents. So
yes. So if you win that raffle, it's only a dollar. Show interview, you guys will be here. Oh, we got a call.
All right. Uh-oh. Who shall it be?
Millionaire Minds with our 2 cents.
Who you, Lope?
Hello?
Hello? Are you there?
Sounds like somebody's there.
Guess not.
Big Boy Blunts.
Hello, caller. Well, guess.
Caller, try calling us again. We're not sure if you had a signal that was lost or whatnot, but feel free to call us back. So.
Yes, please call us back.
But we are definitely going to go ahead and head into Leah Gemini's life.
Yeah.
Stop.
Wait a minute.
Download Sinner's new single, Stop, on iTunes.
Ooh.
All right.
All right, so you guys.
Like the
club. Go ahead and let them know where they can go ahead and download Senna's new single. No, do it again so they can tell you. So you can tell them. Go.
Did you just boss me around?
I didn't.
I don't like the way you point at me when you tell me to do shit. All right? It looks like you're trying to boss me. She does this. Go.
Go.
All right. Look. Watch her do it real quick. Y'all watch.
Do it.
Do it
now that you're pointing me out.
All right, it's not on your voice. So this is what she do. She's like, let me mimic you. Let me mimic you.
Do it.
No, you. Did I do it? You do it.
Go.
Hey, I told you I got her to do it.
I knew he did. Hey, but don't kid us right now. How funny.
But nah, for real, man. Look, go download my homeboy's new single. It's called Stop on iTunes. All right, my boy Senna, man. You got to. If you don't, man. Hey, you stupid.
Yes, he definitely. When I tell y'all, he ripped that up on Saturday.
Y'all missed it.
I'm talking about for real. So, hey, the next opportunity that we have for him to come to Atlanta, he's definitely going to share that with you guys. And, I mean, he's going to give us an exclusive.
Oh, snap.
In the near future, ain't that right, Senna? So, yes. We'll definitely get everything worked out and you will find out the details. So, you guys, Leah Gemini's lightning round.
I've been waiting for this.
I'm about to win.
I've been waiting for this.
Again.
Okay. So, we had just the regular lightning round where I give you 2 choices and you choose one of the 2 options, okay?
Okay.
And then I also have my twisted riddles. So I'm going to give you guys a couple of those after. Yes, so y'all ready? Right. Are you guys ready listening? Y'all
yes,
looking?
Yes, yes.
Y'all ready?
We ready.
Right. You ready?
I ain't ready.
Luke Cage or Wolverine?
Luke Cage.
Yeah, Wolverine.
How many of you guys know about Luke Cage? A lot of people do not know a thing about Luke Cage.
I know about really Luke Cage, but I still, you know what? Fuck that. I think Wolverine will beat his ass.
Nah. Hey. Luke Cage.
You only said that because he's black.
No.
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 No,
no, that's not why.
That's just
because I like Wolverine too.
I like Wolverine too, yeah, but
in a fight, he'll get mollywopped.
You can't even penetrate Luke Cage's skin.
Right. Well, you know why? Guess what? First of all, Luke Cage don't even like to fight. Wolverine waking up waiting to whoop your ass. I'm going with the Wolverine.
Luke Cage, he knows that he's unstoppable.
He can defend
himself. He's unstoppable, so he don't fight. Luke Cage.
Mad Dog just said.
What?
Luke Cage is biblical.
I get that.
He's not trying to whoop nobody ass.
Exactly, but the fact is, if he has to, he knows what his strengths are. Right. And at the end of the day, I put him up against Superman.
Yeah, I would too.
I would.
Yeah.
So three of our listeners just said Wolverine, Luke Cage is biblical. You can't penetrate Wolverine either. Remember the metal experience. The metal experience.
But you can kill Wolverine.
But imagine how.
Actually, no, you can't.
Wolverine. See this? Look, and the thing is, they both have something that.
And he heals himself.
He does heal himself. Yeah. But see, the thing is, you can't even penetrate, do anything, shoot, stab Luke Cage for him to have
to recuperate
heal from. So, yeah, but that's a good one, right? Y'all like that one?
That's just
okay.
That
was all right. How about this?
You got some cookies.
All right, look at this. All right, so Scarface or Godfather?
Oh, my goodness. All
right. Wonder Woman or Storm?
Storm.
I'm going with Storm because you know why?
She can fly.
Holly Berry.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Storm,
all right.
We going with Storm, and guess what?
Storm blow Wonder Woman up.
Exactly. She gives you a little hurricane.
What
that little lasso going to do?
Nothing.
Nothing. Okay.
All right. Nothing. So how about this? Smack Battle Rap or BET Cyphers?
BET Cyphers.
BET Cyphers.
All right. How about this? Wildin' Out or Key & Peele?
Hold on, have you actually watched Key & Peele?
I have binge watched Key & Peele. Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
Have you? You watch Key & Peele? You ain't watched yet?
I can't really say nothing on that, but
my man Scooby also downloaded. Hey Scooby, drop the music in the comments so we can let him know what's happening. Yes. He said Wildin' Out.
I say Wildin' Out.
You say Wildin' Out too. Like I'm not gonna, bro. You know what? I'm gonna say Key & Peele for the simple fact is, sometimes if I don't like the person that's really performing later, I might not really watch it.
Right.
But I can stay up watching Key & Peele. God, I'm sorry.
Key & Peele is hilarious, but I love Wildin' Out. I love the improv behind it. I love.
So Wildin' Out had me cracking up from the beginning.
So that one is hard. That was a good one.
That was
a
good one. You on point today.
So what about this one? Long Beach or Miami Beach?
Miami Beach.
No, you got some folks that will rep Long Beach hard, and they don't care what you comparing it to.
I'm curious. Well, you know what? I don't even give a fuck about the other option, all right?
I love doing this because I love getting the react. I love the reaction. Okay, so how about this one?
Right.
How about this one? The SEC championships or the NFL playoffs?
I have no idea.
Callie, are you stuck again?
No. First of all, I'm gonna say the NFL playoffs. Because guess what? The SEC championship, Alabama always in that motherfucker. Right?
So you tired of seeing the same?
Tired of seeing the same. At least in the NFL playoffs, you can have some surprises. So, Yeah, NFL all the way. Plain Cigarillo says the NFL. Oh yeah, that's what. Yeah, somebody said Long Beach too. Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Santa, we don't give a shit that you're in Florida.
Of course,
you
he
from
goes
Miami. Goddamn, you supposed to. All right. And Roll Tide, Plain Cigarillo, shut up.
What he say?
No one cares about Roll Tide.
All right, so look, you guys, I am about to go into a couple of my twisted riddles. Y'all ready?
Uh-huh.
So these twisted riddles, of course, you only have one answer.
Right.
And, of course, you got some folks who got the little whatever in their mind, but I'm finna go ahead and test y'all. Y'all ready? All right. All right. Tom's height is 6 feet. He's an assistant at a butcher's shop and wears a size 9 shoe. What does he weigh?
Say that shit again. Tom is 6 foot.
Tom's height, his height is six feet.
Okay. It's 6 feet.
Tom's height is 6 feet.
Okay.
He's an assistant at a butcher shop and wears a size 9 shoe. Okay. What does he weigh?
What does he weigh?
What does he weigh?
He weighs the meat. You already cut it, right?
Because he is an assistant at a butcher shop. See, that was the part of the sentence, the question that's supposed to throw you guys off. So
it's
yeah.
All.
Yeah.
Big boy blunts. Stop.
All right. What occurs once in every minute, twice in every moment, yet never in 1,000 years?
Say it one more time. I will.
What occurs?
I was.
What occurs once in every minute, twice in every moment, yet never in 1,000 years?
An eclipse?
No.
Oh, no.
The same time.
No.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Y'all help me
Are you
out.
Trying to get some help from our viewers?
Okay, the face.
No.
Okay, good.
Cigarillo,
again, listen to me, listen. What occurs once in every minute, twice in every moment, yet never in 1,000 years?
Child support.
No! Hey, hey, y'all say that.
Shout out, Jay. Child support. Yeah,
yeah. All right. Y'all give up?
No, we don't give up.
What
we look like giving up, LeBron?
Oh,
sorry.
Y'all crazy.
Say it one more time. We can't hear you.
All right, so I'm going to turn this down so y'all can hear me real good.
Okay.
What occurs once in every minute, twice in every moment, yet never in 1,000 years?
Seconds?
No.
Big boy blunts.
Y'all ready for it?
Love?
No.
What?
The letter M. M occurs
oh,
in minutes.
Literally.
Once.
Oh.
And it occurs twice in the moment. M O M. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That was a good one.
See, it had all y'all stuck.
No, plain. No, first, it's not Eclipse. This motherfucker came up with some shit. Alright. And she came up with some shit. So she said, this is what she said. She said the letter M.
The letter M.
The letter M. You know what I gotta say to that?
Okay, I got one more. I got one more. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Y'all ready out there?
We ready.
Alright. A girl who was just learning to drive went down a one-way street in the wrong direction, but didn't break the law. How is that possible?
Wait, one more time.
She went the right way.
No. A girl who was just learning to drive went down a one-way street in the wrong direction, but
she wasn't driving the car.
She was walking?
She was walking. So both of y'all, yeah, y'all kind of
helped each other on that. Oh, if she wasn't driving... She was walking.
If she wasn't driving, she could have been riding. But you never said she was walking.
I didn't have to. Because you said she was driving.
She was learning. She was learning.
But when
how
I
to
said
drive.
She wasn't driving, that should just let you know the bitch was walking.
You can't say that. Nope.
Yeah, I can. Mm-mm. I just said it.
You were partially right. It don't count.
You partially kissed my I mean, fuck it. I gotta go.
Yes. So, hold on, you guys, man. What do we have coming up? So, what is the word with Cousin Comedy?
All right. So, Cousin Comedy this month. We still don't have a date on it, so with all honesty, we might not have one this month. I will keep everybody informed, but best believe, Ho 20
definitely on.
Cousin Comedy is definitely going to be there.
Yes.
So we definitely going to do that. Also, tonight, once again, check out the MVP show starring me, your boy DC the Model.
Oh, yeah.
Nick and... Damn, why you just made me fuck up again? Nick and Advocate, my own boy. Look, I see y'all in a minute, man. So, you know, check us out tonight. And, Big Boy Blunts.
Big Boy Blunts.
Lean in my crib.
Yes, so you guys definitely stay tuned for our special guest that will be coming next week on Monday. I'm not going to sit up here and tell you who yet, but... just know that that rest rich is sliding. I know y'all like that, right?
Bitch, I be sliding.
I'm gonna start the show off with that. So you guys have to come back next Monday to make sure that you are tuned in and see who our special guest is gonna be. We're definitely gonna have more tracks, you guys. If you're an artist out there and you want to submit your music, make sure you send it to Millionaire Minds with our 2 Cents Radio Show. The email is mmwo2c@gmail.com. So that's Millionaire Minds with our 2 Cents. Just get the acronym at gmail.com. All right. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Instagram is Millionaire Minds 2 Cents. And our Facebook page is Millionaire Minds with our 2 Cents, you guys. Also follow me, Leah Gemini Boss Model, on Facebook and Instagram. You can follow True Being on Instagram at
True Being, TRUBEING, on Facebook and Instagram.
All right. And Callie?
Hey, look, you can find me on Facebook, Callie Bo Williams. You can find my page, my other page, Callie Bo Comedy. And you can also find me on Instagram. That's Callie Bo with 2 underscores. You'll see the symbol. You'll see the brand. You see it right there? Hold on. Time out. Oh, yeah. Shouts out to Ain't the World 365, Queenie. You see the work?
Yes.
You go on my Instagram, you'll see that too. So, yeah, follow me and I'll follow you.
Yes, you guys. So, again, we apologize for our interruption on our Facebook Live feed earlier, you guys. There are 2-3 videos out there, and you can actually recap the show. We will be back this week still.
Oh, yes.
So that we can go ahead and do another retaping of this show.
That's right.
So anything that you may have missed, you guys, we will definitely be recapping live in the studio later on this week. I want to say about Thursday-ish. So we'll let you guys know. Make sure y'all tune in each and every Monday with Millionaire Minds with our 2 cents on WAENFM.com.
Peace.
Hey.